The owner of a Cheektowaga strip club now stands accused of a number of crimes as federal prosecutors investigate the possible resurgence of the Buffalo Mafia. iTeam Chief Investigator Charlie Specht shows us the potential crimes investigators are looking into.
Until recently, Peter Gerace's biggest legal fight was trying to get a judge to overturn COVID-19 restrictions at local businesses.
We're not asking for any handouts. All we want to do is go back to work.
But now, the owner of Farrow's Gentlemen's Club has more pressing legal issues, namely the indictment filed this week that accuses him of allegedly paying bribes to a federal agent. Gerace was arrested in Florida this past weekend while on vacation on charges of conspiracy, drug distribution, and bribery, as well as sex trafficking. He pleaded not guilty, and his attorney, Joel Daniels, did not return our phone call seeking comment. But the indictment stated that Gerace paid cash bribes on a recurring basis to protect himself and his business, Farrow's Gentlemen's Club, from federal narcotics investigations. Prosecutors say the recipient of those bribes was Joseph Bongiovanni, a former DEA agent who was arrested as part of the same federal probe in November 2019. Bongiovanni's attorney says the government has shown no proof of the bribes, but the feds say the agent secretly protected individuals he believed to be members of, connected to, or associated with Italian organized crime in the Western District of New York. Gerace is the nephew of Joseph Todaro, who the FBI accused decades ago of running the Buffalo Mob, though those charges have never been proven in court.
Well, you know, historically, when you bring charges of that are that serious, you bring in what's called a racketeering case, a RICO case. And in those cases, you're proving that there's the entity and organization, there's a criminal enterprise, there's leadership, there's structure.
Peter Ahern is a former special agent in charge of the Buffalo office of the FBI. He says there's a difference between an organized criminal syndicate like the Mafia and those who are just committing crimes.
If you're a relative sometimes and you have that propensity to be a criminal, a lot of times you definitely want to use that at your advantage to get people to fear you and to do things for you.
At this point, government lawyers have not laid out a racketeering case in court, and most observers say the mob in Buffalo was thought to be all but extinct by the early 2000s. The question now is whether La Cosa Nostra has found new life.
But again, does that make it the mob, or does it make it the mob is back just because of that? And that seems to be the question here.
Charlie Speck, 7 Eyewitness News.